There we go, the marvelous one, Marvelous Marvin Gaye, Sexual Healing on a Tuesday morning. Good morning, Double R Radio. Bam, bam, ba dabber, dabber, 8:24, April the 28th, 2020. Man, oh man, oh man. I'm still shaking the cobwebs here, man. So look, cut me some slack. Be nice, por favor. Let me see here, I got a whole lot to talk about. Let's see, where do I want to go? No, I don't want to go there. We'll go here first, and then we'll mess around with this one over here, and then we'll try that one over there, and we'll go back over here, and let's get back over there. That's a good one there, too. There we go. We'll go over here. See, this is work, man. This isn't easy what I'm doing. This is work. What are you doing, Robert? I'm setting up what I need to talk about here. This is work. Anyways, good morning, Tuesday morning. Good morning, Chad. Good afternoon, Micaela Cohen. Good morning, Michelle. How we doing? Also, good morning, Chad. Good afternoon, Diana Cáceres. Buenos días, Diana. Normalinda Esquivel. Man, that thing, I'm Normalinda. Man, my Spanish is flowing this morning. It really is. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. This morning, my Spanish is flowing. That's right. Anyways, what a weekend, man. Really, man. It's just like, wow. Yesterday was one of those kind of days that I want to put to the side, forget about yesterday, and today's another day. Just yesterday, man, was just, You know, I was going to come home and crack open the Michelob Ultra, and I said, man, I got to get my system a rest here, man. The Michelob Ultra, Tuesday, Wednesday, I got to get my system a rest. I said, no beer drinking yesterday. So I said, I'm going to make it an alcohol-free Monday, no doubt. Now, that being said, let's see what's going on. Check this out, man. I got some crazy stories for y'all. Let's go here first. We'll go here. No, I already got that one. We'll go here. There we go. Check this out. Walmart is going to be adding one-way aisles to stores, at least here in San Antonio, to help with social distancing. How crazy is this, right? For now, Walmart, whenever you're going through the aisles, it's all one way. You can only go one way. That's it. You can't go two ways, like, you know, two people facing each other. Only one way. So, look here, I hardly go to Walmart, so this ain't going to affect me too much. But regardless, man, for a lot of people out there, it's going to be weird. Where it's going to be now they're treating you like traffic, like cattle, where you can only go one way on the aisles at Walmart. To be honest with you, I like the idea. If we're talking about social distancing and taking care of business and trying to have people stay away from each other, this is really, man, I really like this idea. That's because I'm not going to be the one stuck in line trying to get by somebody. Now, it's just going to be interesting, but I really like the one-way angle that Walmart has created for social distancing. I really do. I think it's going to work. I'm going to say, hey, man, wait a minute. I just got to go get that 12-pack right there. Well, you got to go through the one-way, then go through here, go through there. But the 12-pack's right over there. You got to go over there. But the 12-pack's right there. You got to go over there. My question is this. What's going to happen if you decide not to go and do the one-way thing? Are they going to give you a ticket? Or what? Are they going to throw you out? That's my question right here. What are they going to do for the people who do not want to recognize this one-way system and just kind of do whatever they want to do? Going to be interesting. It really, really is. Good morning, Chad. I got out to Double R Radio sponsor, partner, Mr. James Gonzalez, Money Mart Pawn Shop. Good morning, amigo. How we doing? Anyways, let's see here. What else is going on? So, okay. Hey, so now expect that, at least from what I'm seeing here, the Walmarts here in San Antonio, they are now doing the one-way aisles deal for all customers. It's going to be interesting. Now, check this out. Crazy story. An Oregon man. You know, I reported this last week that Wendy's were giving away 4 chicken nuggets for free. You didn't have to buy french fries, a soda, a burger. All you had to do was go through the drive-thru at Wendy's and ask them for the free nuggets, and you'd get 4 nuggets. I talked about this. Now, check this out. Ow! And an Oregon man visited 11 different Wendy's. He went to 11 different Wendy's to get those 4-piece chicken nuggets. What a loser! Man, just go get your 4 nuggets and leave. But no, this Oregon man went and visited 11 different Wendy's in a 5-hour time span to get his free chicken nuggets. Go figure. There we go. As the Michelle says, called. No, Michelle, they're not going to call the police. Michelle, put a phone. I mean, I cannot see Walmart calling the police on somebody going up the wrong way on an aisle at Walmart. I can see maybe having a couple of bouncers taking you to the back of Walmart and, you know, a couple of baseball bats. All right. But don't call the police. Anyways, there you go. So, a character in Oregon visited 11 Wendy's to get his four-piece chicken. See, now, 11 times 4, that's 44 nuggets in 5 hours. Is it worth it? I don't think so. Anyways, crazy ride. Let's see here what else, man. I got a bunch here for you. Now, here we go. Here's a good one. I'm just trying to get all this together here. Now, there we go. Check this out, San Antonio, Texas, man. Hey, man, we're grabbing the spotlight here. Anyways, two women were arrested for breaching this social distancing thing. Now, these two women are beauticians. Okay, they cut hair, they do their thing. Well, anyways, all beauty salons are closed. So what they tried doing was they were trying to do services, their beautician services, from their casa. Somebody reported them, and there you go. It's all said and done. They were both arrested. How crazy. You know, I even told my daughter about this. My daughter's a beautician. And I told her, can you cut my hair? She goes, no, Dad, it's illegal. And I go, well, can you catch your sister? So she went, no, Dad, it's illegal. I cannot be operating from the house. Not even a family member? Not even a family member. But I'm your dad. I can't do it, Dad. Really, mija? All right. Okay. But really, my daughter stuck to her guns. She says, no, Dad, beauticians cannot be operating out of their house. Interesting, right? It really, really is. Now, let's see here. What else is going on? Now, you know, I am going to go here only because this is really, really interesting. Let's see here. Let's go there. There we go. You know, this caught my attention. I was kind of going through news stories yesterday, and I saw this headline that said, what did people do before toilet paper was invented? Okay, and I said, hey, man, that's interesting. What did people do before toilet paper was invented? And mind you, before I get to the story, let me share something with you guys. Yesterday, I picked up a lady who works at HEB, and she was sharing HEB stories with me. Now, this is one story that she told me, which was, she said, so many people, they were trying to scam the toilet paper thing. When we were trying, she said, when HEB was trying to do one family member only through the house, they'd bring their daughter, their son, and they were all buying toilet paper. She claimed that there was this one woman that tried bringing back $400 worth of toilet paper. She wanted a refund, and HEB on the toilet paper angle has a no refund policy. But for her to want to get a refund on $400 worth of toilet paper, how in the heck, first off, did she get so much toilet paper? $400 worth of toilet paper. Man, that's crazy. It really, really is. Anyways, so getting back to my story here, now this headline caught my attention. It says, what did people use before using toilet paper? Well, I did some homework on this, and you're not going to believe this, man. I was like, no way. Back in the day before disco, before the Alamo, right? People used to use seashells. How does that work? How do you use a seashell as toilet paper? And I'm thinking, man, I don't even want to think about it. How in the heck did people use seashells? And no lie, man, I'm not joking around. People used to use seashells as toilet paper. Crazy, right? It really, really is. Now, check this out. Here we go. Let's talk freebies. Taco Bell today is giving away. Let me see here. How many tacos are they giving away? Taco Bell is giving away 2 free tacos. You don't got to buy a soda. You don't got to buy anything. Taco Bell is giving away 2 free tacos today. So, look, if you're passing by Taco Bell and you're hungry, you want 2 free tacos, just go to Taco Bell, get in that drive-thru, and get yourself 2 free tacos. It doesn't cost a dime. There's no gimmick. There's no kicker to anything. Taco Bell is giving away 2 free tacos today. And it doesn't matter if you're in Houston, you're in Dallas, you're in San Antonio, I don't care where you're at. Nationwide, Taco Bell, they're giving away 2 free tacos. There you go. Am I going to go? No. No, I can only imagine the lines at Taco Bell just to get in there, just to get to. It's kind of like, do y'all remember when IHOP was doing free pancakes? I tried that one time. It's not going to happen. I don't think so, man. One time I said, maybe I'll go get some free pancakes at IHOP. When I showed up at IHOP, you should have seen the line wrapped around the building for 2 free pancakes. Really? I don't think so. I got some microwave waffles right here. I'll put those babies in the hair fryer, and we'll be good to go. But anyways, for the person who wants to go get their free tacos, Taco Bell, there we go. It's the Diana Costa that says, I'm going to go visit 11 Taco Bells. Órale, Diana, pues tú sabes, Diana, come on, hey. So anyways, you know, on a side note, I like Taco Bell. Taco Bell ain't so bad. I like only their tacos. I don't like that burrito surprise. That burrito surprise is they put whatever they want into it, and it's a surprise, and that's true. Let's keep it going. AJ Castillo, Oye Mujer. Good morning, Double R Radio. How we doing, everybody? Tuesday morning. You know, last night, man, we had some thunderstorms move through San Antonio. It was thundering. It was lightning. For a minute there, I thought it was that bean burrito. But nope, it was thundering. It was lightning. And it woke me up. I was up for about 30 minutes. I couldn't go back to sleep. I turned on the TV, started watching MASH, and I said, man, I'm going to put the timer on my TV, and hopefully I'll fall asleep. And that I did. But we're expecting more rain this evening here in San Antonio. Let's see what happens. Let's get back to the morning show. Join me, RobertRivasRadio.com. Simple, RobertRivasRadio.com. Just click on that media player button. You'll be joining me live. Órale, join me now. Out.